Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate you how you can create multi-pick list in Salesforce. So before starting, you can know how you can search me on YouTube. You can type my name and you can watch a series of Salesforce related videos. So now I'm going to create a multi-pick list for custom object that is student. So I'm going to search this object. So in my previous video, I demonstrated you how you can create a simple pick list. So here you will learn to create multi-pick list. So let me tell you the basic difference between these two. So here you can read about the pick list. So pick list allow users to select a value from a list you define, whereas multi-pick list allows users to select multiple values from a list you define. So as the name suggests, multi-pick list will allow you to select multiple values, more than one, or you can choose one also, one or more than one. Whereas in pick list, you can select only one option from the available options. So now I'm going to select pick list, multi-select, clicking on next. So here, I need to write the name of the label. So I'm clicking on subject. So again, we have two options, use global pick list value set, or you can enter values at your own. So in my previous video, I demonstrated a global pick list value set that is country. So country is not suitable for this because here we need to write the subject's name. So I'm choosing this option. If you have created any global pick list value set that is related to this subject, like you have different objects where you are going to use the subject multi pick list. So for that purpose, you can create a common global pick list value set and you can choose that here. But in our case, we don't have any global pick list value set for subjects. So I'm writing them explicitly. So I'm writing math, science, not commerce, English, history, political science, economics, computer, IT, networks. So I mentioned these values as the pick list value set. Then we have three options. Display values alphabetically and display first value as the default value. So these are pretty clear by their description. So if you want to wish to select a particular option, you can click on the checkbox as selected. Like we want to show all these values as alphabetical order. I'm not selecting second option because I don't want to choose a particular value as default value. Then this is by default selected, restrict pick list to the values defined in the value set. So you cannot enter any other value except these values defined here. Then we have number of visible lines. So we can apply a scrolling box on the page. So you can increase or decrease this value. Then field API name is subject. You can write particular description or a help text. You can make it as required field. Then I'm selecting visible for all the profiles. So it will be visible and editable for all the profile. And it will be available on the student page layout. So I'm clicking on save. Now I'm clicking on the student tab, clicking on new. So here you can see, it is showing available lines as 4. Here scroll bar is available and all the values are alphabetically arranged. So you can select a particular value and click on this button. So it will shift to the right hand side. So left hand side box is showing available values and right hand side box is showing chosen values. You can select any other value. By chance, if you selected wrong value, you can click and remove it by clicking on this button. So it will be available on this box again. So this way you can choose values for multiples. So if you have more values, so scroll bar will be added on chosen box also, right? Now let's see what happens when we save this record. So you can see all the selected values are available as comma separated. If you click on edit, again, you will find out those available and chosen boxes for multiple list. So this way you can create multiple list values for both standard as well as custom objects. I hope you understood how we can create multiple list and how it is different from pick list. So again, I'm showing you how you can get me on YouTube. You can watch various Salesforce related videos on my channel. Thank you for watching this video.